Newton North. I'm Emma Bradshaw, and welcome to the last Newton North update of this year. And for the first time since March 2020, I am back in the studio, maskless, with my crew safely working hard from another room. This year has been a roller coaster of highs and lows. However, we wanted to say thanks to everyone for sticking with us, and we've loved having the honor of keeping you informed throughout this strange year. Recently, there have been a string of break-ins happening in our community. Reporter Andrew Hirschberg talked with the police for more on the story to see how residents can better keep their homes safe.
10 years ago, Newton was the safest city in America. Recently, a string of home break-ins have reminded Newton residents that they aren't exempt from danger.
In one night, there are 5 break-ins in our city. We spoke to Newton Community Outreach Officer Justin Lau to see what residents can do to stay safe.
Intruders have been using household items to break in.
Residents have ladders laying around, if you can secure it within the home so it's not easily accessible, because a lot of these items were used to access second floor windows. Try to secure your home as much as possible. If you have a security system, activate it. Definitely lock your doors. Anytime that they were accessed without forced entry, they walk through the back door.
In the most recent break-ins, intruders have went straight to the bedrooms to look for valuables and have not harmed anyone.
With the people that were residing currently within the homes, anytime there was contact made, the perpetrators ran outside and exited the area immediately. So they're not looking for conflict.
Officer Lau also recommends Nest and Ring doorbell cameras. They have high quality footage that can be checked instantly.
You know, not only is that a prevention, but it also helps us. It helps us catch them. It helps get a picture, the videos of them. That's what helps us track them down in the end.
Hopefully now you can sleep a little better at night. Remember, lock your doors, and if you see something, say something. For New North TV, this is Andrew Hirschberg signing off. Stay safe.
Thanks, Andrew. Those are some great tips we'll be sure to remember. Next up, reporter Sam Melville went around the area to find out what people think about the hottest new controversial topic affecting our community.
Spring has sprung. The sun is shining. The flowers are blooming. We're all back in school. And one thing is on everyone's mind. The Walnut Street benches.
The Walnut Street benches are pretty cool. I like to sit on them.
I didn't notice them until now.
How do you feel about the Walnut Street benches?
The what?
I actually really like them. I've sat there a few times, waiting outside
Great Harvest
to get my sandwich.
What benches? Stripped down to my
skin and my bones. They're definitely quality benches. I like them.
I personally have not seen or sat on these benches.
I like it. It's good.
They seem like weird and modern, and the rest of Newtonville does not feel like that.
The modern world is taking over Newtonville's charm.
I think they're cool. Trying to see
if Beyonce will take me for adoption. Well, as you can see, the Walnut Street benches are all the rage here in Newtonville. Everyone's sitting in them. Everyone's talking about them. And I wouldn't want to miss out. For Newton North TV, I am Sam Melville.
Wow, looks like Sam really loved those hip new benches. So cool. Next up, on a more serious note, in memory of those who have unfortunately passed away due to the coronavirus in our Newton community, Ana-Karina Adrianza visited Mason Rice where the first trees were being planted for the 4C Tree Memorial.
This spring, you may have noticed tree saplings popping up around the city. In Newton's public spaces, beautiful trees are being planted to honor our town's COVID victims and to push our community towards being environmentally friendly. The 4C Tree Project, which stands for Capture, Carbon, Commemorate COVID, was started by college student Elizabeth Stockwell with the help of the Environmental Youth Leadership Program.
And it's a way to both show we care for each other and care for those who have died tragically during this time, and also to show that we care for the earth.
In an act of remembrance and support, Newton community members gathered at Mason Rice Elementary School on May 1st for the symbolic planting of the first few trees to emphasize the importance of the project.
I think it's a really nice way to commemorate the lives lost to COVID in Newton, and it can also sort of give back to the environment and just like beautify, make the spaces in Newton more beautiful.
The trees will act as not just memorials, but also a sign of the green future Elizabeth and the leadership program envision for Newton.
Trees inspire people to stop, sit, relax, and kind of ponder life. And so at the same time, people can reflect on the pandemic.
Community involvement in helping Newton reach a green future is important, and the 4C Tree Project is only one of many ways to be involved in honoring town members and the beautiful nature around us.
This is an ongoing project, so we really are still kind of looking for ways to get more people involved.
From NNTV, this is Ana-Karina Adrianza signing off.
Our condolences to those we have lost in our community and their families. Having to socially distance has led many of us to feel lonely and isolated, but kindness can go a long way to make us feel closer and appreciated. Reporter Alex Katz, aka the Compliment Kid, took to Newtonville to bring some cheer.
Hello everyone, my name is Alex Katz, and today for Happy Kindness Day, we are going around Newtonville and complimenting people because I am the compliment kid. So let's go. Let's go. Okay.
It's such a beautiful day outside. I wonder what the compliment kid will bring today.
You guys are doing amazing. Keep up the good work. It's your birthday. Happy birthday to you. Woo. Yes! Woo. I love your pink jacket, ma'am. It looks beautiful.
Thank you. What about my friend's jacket?
Oh, wonderful too. I didn't even see it. Yes. Get it?
Thank you.
Get it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Those flowers on your shirt look wonderful, ma'am. Oh, thank you so much. I love your sign.
Thank you. You guys are doing amazing. Keep up the good work.
What?
I am so confused right now.
You're doing amazing, sir.
All right, thank you. Appreciate that. Complimentary.
Yes. I love your mask. It's so colorful. You're welcome. Hello, everyone. How's everyone doing today?
Good.
I love that bag. It's so colorful. I love your shirt, sir. It's wonderful.
Thank you.
Great hat. I love your purse, bag thing. It looks wonderful. Your shirts look amazing.
Thanks.
Hello. How are you doing today? Good, I love your sweatshirt.
Well, thank
you. You're welcome, have a good day.
What are you doing?
I'm the compliment kid, I'm spreading compliments.
Hi.
You have wonderful shoes, they look wonderful.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, you're the compliment.
Yes, I am.
Wonderful. Thank you for complimenting.
Of course. Have a great day.
Thank you. Well, that's very kind of you.
Thank you.
Have a nice day.
You too.
Nice sign.
Thank you so much. Have a good day.
You too.
Compliment, kid.
Thank you. Your dog is so beautiful. Enjoy your ice cream.
Thank you. Hey, have a great day.
Thank you. You too. I love your butterfly. It looks wonderful. Your watch looks wonderful.
Much.
You're welcome. I love your purse.
Thank you.
You're welcome. I'm on a roll. Beautiful flowers.
What? Oh, thank you.
Beautiful flowers. Have a good day.
Yeah, you too.
Oh, your shirt is so colorful. It looks great.
I appreciate it.
Thank you. I'm not selling anything. I'm just selling happiness and kindness. Your hair looks wonderful today.
Oh, thanks.
You're welcome. Have a good day. That's a really cool shirt, sir.
Oh, thank you.
Have a good rest of your day.
You too.
Enjoy your burritos. Those look like some good burritos. Hello. Your pink shirt looks amazing on you.
Thank you.
You watching. You have a beautiful smile. For NNTV, this is Alex Katz signing off.
What a great way to spread some love. Every level of school has been affected by the pandemic, and we know how it has affected us in our community, but college is a different story. So, reporter Jonathan Hachi went and talked to some college students about their college quarantine experience.
This past year has been difficult for everyone in many different ways, but especially so for students, including my sister, who's the first person I talked to about the past year of college in quarantine. Lily graduated from North in 2019 and has been attending Pitzer College since then.
I was going to work at a lab this year. I wasn't able to because the lab wasn't running, so I lost a whole year of experience. In addition to that, I feel like if I had been on campus, I would have made friends, whereas right now I'm just like trying to maintain all of my college friendships. So in that way, I'm really lucky that I'm a sophomore because I already like know people. I mean, I feel like I missed out on everything college has to offer, except for like I have been learning a lot in my classes, so there's that.
Sometimes it's better to not know what you're missing out on, which is made clear by Doug, who had the opportunity to live on campus at the University of Chicago. He graduated from North in 2020.
I honestly have been having a really good time. I think part of it is because I'm a freshman, there weren't necessarily the same expectations. Like if I had, for example, come to college and been like, this is the college experience that I know and deserve, and then I lose it the next year, there's like that, oh no, like this is what I lost. For me, I'm leaving high school and I'm sort of already in that unknown. So there isn't as much of a sense of loss, at least personally. And I think another part of it too is I'm sort of a busybody. So for me, like in high school, it was always just work. So coming here and being able to just sort of reevaluate that, being able to be out there even a little is honestly just a huge dub.
Sam also only graduated from North last year and is currently attending Tufts University while at home, only 30 minutes away from campus. And even though he's at home, he was able to find what he was looking for from college this year.
I wanted to come to college. I wanted to make some friends. I wanted to learn. I wanted to take interesting classes, and I think I was able to hit all of those checkpoints. I may not have formed the relationships with my professors that I would have preferred to, but I think overall it was a positive experience.
For those of you who are going off to college soon, here's a piece of advice that the alumni shared with me. Try to reach out to new people and ask others to do stuff. Whether it be going out or studying, it never hurts to make new friends and connections. For NNTV, this is Jonathan Hachi, signing off.
Thanks, Jonathan. As you probably know, the last day for seniors is this Friday. We've changed so much since we were younger, but there are many ways in which we are still the same. I sat down with two kindergartners and two members of the graduating class to see how students change over their years in school.
I'm Emily Parkman.
My name is Emma Schwartz.
What is your name?
Chloe. Marco.
What do you want to be when you grow up?
I want to be a dressmaker because I want to be like my grandma and my mommy.
Undecided, but I think when I was little, I wanted to be a vet.
I want to help like save kittens and everything.
Right now, I want to be a sports medicine doctor, and actually, I have wanted to be a doctor since I was in kindergarten.
Who's important to you?
My mom and my friends.
My sister, my mom, and dad.
I would definitely say my family and my close friends.
My friends and family, my cousins.
Yeah. What is your proudest accomplishment?
I think that would have to be competing my senior solo in dance this year.
Helping a friend up.
Getting into college or getting my license. Those were, I didn't think I was gonna get my license when I took the test.
I'm proud of helping other people.
My friends and spending time with my family.
Meeting new people.
My friends and lacrosse.
When I get hugs from my mom and dad because I get warmer when I'm cold and I'm happier when I'm sad.
Do you have any advice for the seniors?
Yeah. Saying hello and saying what's your name and do you want to be friends? I hope you have friends and you can ask if you want to be, if they want to be your friends.
Do you have any advice for the kindergartners?
I would definitely say just enjoy your time during school because it moves way faster than you think it will.
With that, we wanted to end our last NN update of the year and our Major 3's very last NN update by giving appreciation to the seniors. We rocked it this year and made it the best we could have done with the tools that we had. Go on and do great things. That's all we have for this year's announcements. It's been a pleasure being your anchor, and NNTV will see you next year. From NNTV, this is Emma Bradshaw signing off.